Blessed is our God, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen. Glory to thee, O God, glory to thee, O heavenly King, the comfort of the Spirit of truth, for it everywhere fills all things, treasury of blessings and giver of life. Come and abide in us, cleanse us from every impurity, and save our souls from good causes. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Lord, have mercy on us. Holy God,
Christ himself, our King and our God.
us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the welfare of the holy churches of God and the union of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
and for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this country, its president, for all civil authorities, and for the armed forces, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city, for every city and countryside, and for the faithful dwelling in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Seasonable weather, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by land and by sea and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have
that we may be delivered from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Remembering our most holy, most pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady Theopolis, ever Virgin Mary, of all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other in all our life unto Christ our God.
Glory.
Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Since the offering of Jesus God for the Holy Spirit to pray for the seed of God, may we all send out a blessing for the divine grace.
Receive the voice of my prayer.
Thank you.
all wisdom, the prokimenon is the victor. Save me, O God, by thy name, and judge me by thy strength.
Save me, O God, by thy name, and judge me by thy strength.
Hear my prayer, O God, hearken unto the words of my mouth.
Save me, O God.
Now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
God, and our own historical glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and out to ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Amen.
May Christ, our true God, through the prayers of this most pure Mother, of the Holy Glorious and Laudable Apostles, of our Father among the Saints Nicholas, the Wonder Worker, Archbishop of Myra in Lycia, of the holy martyrs Adrian and his wife Natalia, and the 23 others who suffered with them in Nicomedia, whose memories we keep this day, and of all the saints that have shone forth in this North American land, and of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, have mercy on us and save us, for as much as he is good, and he loves men. Christ. Oh, you can do better than that. Glory to Jesus Christ.
Glory to you forever.
That sounds like, that's good. Brothers and sisters, tonight we honor the memory of the holy martyrs Adrian and Natalia. And they have a really quite a beautiful story. They both came from prominent homes in Nicomedia, kind of in modern-day Turkey. And Natalia was secretly a Christian, and Adrian was a pagan, but a good man. And at that time, Maximian was gathering up the Christians for a demonstration, and he went after these 23 Christians who were hiding in a cave, and then eventually were brought into the center of the city, and they came before the praetor, and they were writing their names down in a book. And Adrian, who was not a Christian at this time, saw the Christian demeanor and behavior and became, something changed within him. And he began to speak to these Christians who were about to go to their martyrdom. And these Christians didn't say, "Leave us alone, can't you see we're going through something here?" They shared the message of the gospel with Adrian. Told him about God becoming incarnate as a human person, his desire to unite himself with humanity and the opportunity for eternal life. And Adrian, after spending some time with these Christians who were on their way to martyrdom, went to the praetor and said to him, "You know what? You can write me down too. I am a Christian." And this is a story about reactions. The governor said to him, "What's the matter with you? Have you lost your mind?" And he says, "No, I've come to my senses." And his wife, and they'd just been married 13 months, just a little over a year. When he said he was going to write his name down as a Christian, do you think she said, "What are you, out of your mind?" She was happy, overjoyed, and spent the last moments of Adrian's life encouraging him in the faith. So Adrian, those 23 other Christians, endured the sufferings of martyrdom, being encouraged by Natalia. And ultimately they gave their life for the sake of the gospel, but actually inherited something much greater. And I want to share with you one of the hymns that we sang this evening. I love it when this particular hymn comes up for the martyrs. And it says the following. O Lord, thy martyrs and thy apostles, hardly loving thee on earth, considered all but dung. You know, dung is a really nice word for something else. Right? They considered everything else but dumb. That thee alone they might acquire, and for thee gave over their bodies to wounds, for which sake they are glorified, and they pray for our souls. The Apostle Paul also said he counts all as dumb compared to the gospel
Jesus Christ. And so we too are encouraged in our own particular time to be those people when we see someone living out their Christian life in maybe an intense way, to not be those that say, "What's the matter with you? Have you lost your mind?" But rather to be those who will come beside them and encourage them. Now, not everything that has a religious veneer on it is holy. We have to be very discerning to encourage people towards that right path, which is a relationship with our Lord Jesus Christ and with his saints. But when we see that, to encourage it in one another, to say, don't lose heart, keep the course. As we said on Sunday, keep your eyes focused on Jesus Christ. And if we do that, we know that with the saints, we too will enter the kingdom of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Glory to Jesus Christ.
Glory be to God.
Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.